stressed as we are with pandemic, this worldwide pandemic that all of us are trying to survive as we speak, now we're about to enter into the peak of the hurricane season, a hurricane season that has been projected by the experts at Colorado State University to be above average in the number of storms and the severity of those storms. And already we've seen the earliest ever G storm. I forget the name. We just experienced Tana, mm-hmm. but the next will be the first in the history of naming and recording storms that will have a G storm by this time, by before August, actually. So we need more than ever to be prepared for a significant hurricane season. And I realize in the northern part of our state that's not as threatening as it is down in the coastal regions and even the central part of the state. But my point and my emphasis as I make my storm tour every year, this year I'm doing it virtually from either Baton Rouge in my office or on the road, but not in studio. My message is the best insurance buy any property owner can make anywhere in the state of Louisiana is the significantly subsidized still National Flood Insurance Program, benefiting Louisiana more than any other state by far. And unfortunately, in the Shreveport area, in Caddo Parish, for example, only 4% of the residents have national flood insurance protection for their residents. And in Bossier Parish, it's only 10%. Statewide, that percent is 24%. And 2 years ago, well, 3 years ago now, when the flooding events hit Baton Rouge and Lafayette, those metropolitan areas only had 12% penetration for the residences in those two areas. And lo and behold, those 2 days of 10-inch plus rainstorms flooded thousands of homes in those two areas. It can happen anytime, anywhere in the state of Louisiana. And of course, Shreveport is vulnerable to springtime flooding with the Red River. The rest of the state is always at risk for river overtopping or rain-caused flash flooding, as well as hurricane-related flooding events. So that's my first message. And my second, always, is get with your agent, go over all of your insurance coverages, do a checkup, if you will, on your insurance needs and what you have in place to protect you and your family. It's a good time to do that. And in particular, be aware of what you have in place for wind coverage, hurricane, hailstorm, tornado, etc., because almost every homeowner's policy and almost all commercial property policies nowadays come with a named storm or hurricane deductible, anywhere from 2 to 5%, not of your damage, but 2 to 5% of your insured value. Typically, that's $150,000 to $200,000 for a home. 5% of that can be a significant out-of-pocket expense before your coverage kicks in to repair your roof if a tree limb falls on it and does damage. So those are my two primary messages as I make this now virtual tour of the state as we head into August and September, the peak months of the hurricane season historically for our state and, for that matter, all coastal states.
And, Commissioner, before you go, how many times do you see families being reactive instead of proactive? And what I mean is the hurricane happens, and then they're scrambling to try to get insurance. And by that time, unfortunately, it's too late.
Absolutely. That's almost always the case. As I said, only 24% of the residences have flood insurance. And in those Lafayette and Baton Rouge flooding events in 2016, the typical grant that was made available, we call it the Air Force One effect. After every disaster, whoever the president is flies in, does a tour, and inspects the damage and promises to be there for those victims as they recover. And indeed, they are. They make available grants. On average, in Lafayette and Baton Rouge, it was $9,500. But for those who did have flood insurance, that 12% of those two areas, their average claim was $95,000. and what the federal government does make available to get folks back up and in their homes is an SBA loan, a low interest but 30-year typically SBA loan for the difference between what coverage, if they have any flood coverage available, and the actual cost of that that disaster. And that difference, as I mentioned, is the difference between $9,500 grants and $95,000 in claims payments for folks with flood insurance.
Got you. And for those families that might be struggling this morning, you know, some people don't even have home insurance, car insurance. How affordable is this for all families to where they can protect their families during hurricane season?
That's a great question. And the answer is it is affordable, but you do have to make the effort and make the sacrifice that about $60 a month is the average for a typical home in the state of Louisiana to insure it for flood. Now, that can be more if you're in a low-lying area or in a flood-vulnerable area, but typically statewide, and I would dare say the Caddo-Bossier area is probably, if anything, a little less vulnerable than most of the states, so that it is an affordable coverage, and as I said earlier, it's the most important insurance buy any property owner can make anywhere in the state of Louisiana.
Absolutely.
No doubt about it.
You'd rather be safe than sorry, like you always say.
Absolutely. And please feel free, your listeners, if they have any questions, 800-259-5300, our website, LDI, Louisiana Department of Insurance, .la.gov, 800-259-5300.